A tearful hug made incomplete by a wall. This is no ordinary wall. These metal bars separate Mexico and the United States at Nogales, Arizona.
Love has no borders. The love of a mother and a daughter can't be separated by borders, can't be separated by anything. And for them to remember that they have families as well.
Dales un beso.
24-year-old Evelyn Rivera is an undocumented immigrant. Her mother, Yolanda Rave, was deported to their native Colombia. They're meeting for the first time since she was expelled from the U.S.
I've had a chance
to. Rivera has been able to stay in the country thanks to an executive order issued last June by President Obama. It allows immigrants who are in the United States illegally after being brought here by their parents as children to stay in the U.S. until June of 2014.
This is about incredible young people who understand themselves to be Americans, who have done everything right, but have still been hampered in achieving their American dream.
Back at the border, Gorte Teodoro is meeting her 25-year-old daughter, Renata, for the first time since the Brazilian woman was deported.
I just asked why. I just want to be with my kids. I live in America for almost 50 years. Why deport me?
I just want to be with my mom. I want her to be there at my graduation. I want to go to movie nights again with her.
The reunion of three young immigrants and their deported parents was not a random event. It was coordinated and some expenses paid by United We Dream, an immigrants' rights organization trying to send a message to Congress as lawmakers debate a new immigration bill. According to the Migration Policy Institute, there are nearly 1.8 million children of undocumented immigrants lacking legal status in this country. Bills to legalize them have failed multiple times in Congress in the last decade, but many Republican and Democratic lawmakers are trying to make these so-called dreamers a part of a comprehensive immigration reform bill. Rafael Romo, CNN, Atlanta.